ALS, Alternative Learning Systems.
RCEP, Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. This is an initiative taken by ASEAN countries along with its associates. In fact, 16 members will be there. It is a free trade agreement discussion. RCEP will be a free trade agreement between 10 ASEAN countries. It's plus 3. Plus 3 means China, Japan and South Korea. Plus 1, that is India. Then plus Australia and New Zealand. So 10 ASEAN countries, 3 from the Far East, that is China, Japan, South Korea, plus India, plus Australia, New Zealand. So these 16 countries are negotiating for a free trade agreement, which is to be supposed to be, or they have kept a target of this December 2019, and the negotiation started in 2012. And but there is still no agreement regarding how to go about, or rather there are still lot of loose ends to be tied. India has series of objections towards this because our experience in free trade agreements are not so good, and because of India's objections, things are getting delayed a bit. Even the Malaysian Prime Minister Dr. Mahathir Mohamad even suggested that if India like countries are not ready to join it immediately, let others start it, meaning ASEAN plus 3, China, Japan and South Korea should go ahead and start this RCEP, whereas many other countries believe that no, it should be a comprehensive one, we should not be starting by leaving some people behind, it may not be a good step. So there is still some uncertainty regarding when will we be able to start this RCEP, or when will we be able to start this free trade agreement here. And this FTA partners, I already said the partners will be 16 members will be there, and in fact this will be the largest free trade agreement in the world if it materializes. In fact, it encompasses almost 40% of the global trade among the economies, and then third of the GDP, almost 33% of the global GDP will be here. And also, it will have, almost 26% of the global foreign direct investment and 45% of the global population. It is huge numbers, okay. See, one-third of 40% of the global GDP, we are saying, global trade, and one-third of the global GDP, then 30% of the 26% of the global foreign direct investment and 45% of the global population are involved in this RCEP. But India has raised many concerns about it. See, the fundamental reason for India's concern is our bad experience in the previous free trade agreements. India has certain fundamental weaknesses. First of all, our weakness is our manufacturing sector. In fact, whenever there is a free trade agreement in goods, the other countries are able to export more items to India, and in return India is not able to export anything back because our manufacturing sector is quite weak. Unfortunately, because of the neglect which we have done, historic neglect we have done. See, during the Nehruvian time and the initial years of our socialism, our focus was mainly on the large industries, heavy industries, and not on the consumer goods and other light and the medium goods industries. So, in electronic goods, for example, our manufacturing sector is quite poor. So, whenever we open up in the name of free trade agreement, our market is opened up very easily, and in return, we are not able to export anything back. This is a general concern, and it is a truth also. But any free trade agreement means it will be on goods and manufactured goods. So, naturally, we will have to open it up. That is one worry of India. The second worry is whenever we open up, our agricultural sector is also, we are supposed to open it up. When we open up, our 60% of the people engaged in agriculture, and many of them are engaged only in subsistence agriculture. Ours is not a high quality, high-end agriculture, which is, it is not. Our productivity is one of the weakest and the lowest in the world. So, we are not able to compete with China and other Southeast Asian countries when it comes to agriculture. When it comes to manufactured goods, we are not able to compete because our manufacturing sector, we did not give importance to manufacturing sector before the economic liberalization. After economic liberalization also, unfortunately, we opened our market. We did not give enough support and base for the manufacturing, unfortunately. Then, a third aspect is our strength is in the service sector. But unfortunately, you know, most of these free trade agreements exclude the service sector. We would like to include service sector in it, but unfortunately, most of the countries are not so keen to open up the service sector and also the human capital. The movement of the movement of goods we are agreeing, but movement of the human capital, the movement of you know, human beings, the workers, we would like to open up this more so that we, our Indian skill force can go and travel across and work in other countries also. But unfortunately, that is not agreeable to most of the partners in the RCEP. So, one big issue is, so three issues I said. One is our manufacturing is weak. Second, our agriculture sector is weak because of subsistence nature. The third is our inability. We want the service sector to be included and the movement of the human capital, but unfortunately, it is not agreeable. A fourth point is, when we open, naturally, we are also always worried about China because we are fearing that if a free trade agreement is agreed with China, the Chinese goods will flood Indian market. In fact, in the RCEP, the target is to have free trade in more than 90% of the goods. India is quite okay with the ASEAN countries because we are already having a free trade agreement with ASEAN since 2009. Also, we have an RCEP, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement with Japan and South Korea. So, we have in a some sort of free trade agreement already existing with in 12 countries. But with China, we are very apprehensive. We are talking about we should have a differential treatment for China and we don't want to open up more than 74% of the items from China right now. So, we are very, very apprehensive about the cheap Chinese goods being dumped in India if we participate in the RCEP. And also, another big issue which India is taking out is the issue of the rules of origin. Rules of origin, meaning country of origin, from which country the product is originating, because we fear that in the name of this, the Chinese goods will enter into Indian market through other countries' label and logo, which we don't want. So, which is again, it's a bone of contention between India and other countries when it comes to the country of origin. And in India, the most worried sector right now because of RCEP are steel industry, aluminium industry, copper, textiles and pharmaceuticals, which are these sectors are fearing that this Chinese goods will flood Indian market and there will be a serious problem for these manufacturers. So, these are some of the concerns which we have and some of these concerns are genuine also. And one more point which I did not mention earlier is, out of the 16 countries, India won, so we have trade with 15 countries, with 11 of them, India has a negative trade balance, 11 of them. So, we have positive trade balance only with 4 countries. So, in most cases, we have a negative trade balance. And with China, for example, our trade deficit last year, 2017-18, is almost $60 billion. If the bilateral trade is more than $80 billion, but the deficit is, $60 billion. So, our fear is, if we open up as part of this RCEP, the bilateral trade deficit between India and China will further increase. And China need to do something more. So, that is our bargain point. And as far as China is concerned, what is our demand? We want more market access to China. We are saying, unless China agrees for more access for Indian products in China, we will not be able to sign an RCEP immediately. Because we don't want to widen our trade deficit by joining RCEP. In fact, our demand include we should be allowed to export drugs, sugar, rice, dairy products, soybean, then IT and other services, we should get more access to China. That is one demand. And also, we are concerned about the movement of human capital, which I already said, so that we can reduce our trade deficit with China. And we would also like China to reduce the non-tariff barriers. We are accusing China of preventing our India's export to China by using non-tariff barriers like sanitary and phytosanitary requirements. We are also concerned about the Chinese not giving equal market access to our pharmaceutical products. We have concerns about the China preventing India from exporting milk and milk products, pomegranates, soybean meal, etc. So, we are insisting that China should open up their economy more freely, and Indian products should be able to reach the Chinese market very easily. And China should not be playing with the non-tariff barriers when it comes to the Indian product. So, with China, we have specific demand. We want to reduce the trade deficit rather than allowing it to widen through RCEP. Finally, coming to the conclusion, should India join RCEP or not, if it is so problematic? So, this is a double-edged sword. It is the biggest dilemma India is facing right now. If we join, there are certain advantages. But if we did not join, there are so many disadvantages also. See, for example, despite all the misgivings, general understanding by our experts is that we should join RCEP. Of course, there are certain areas where there will be problems, like steel industry, pharmaceutical industry, there could be problems. But India should try to help, the government should help this sector and try to overcome that problem, or rather to help those people who are engaged in this market manufacturing sector. But there could be, we should bargain so hard that we can get our access of IT sector there, the generic drugs market in the Southeast Asia and the rest of the RCEP countries. So, we should have a good bargain, and wherever we may have some drawback, we should be able to support, the government should support, government should strengthen these sectors. And overall, there should be, we cannot sit out of this kind of RCEP kind of an institution. And once we sit out, we are left out forever. It will not be that easy to catch up. And if anybody, like Malaysian Prime Minister is saying, because of frustration that if India is not interested, let them sit out. But we should not be thinking of sitting outside. It will be extremely premature from India's side to think about sitting outside. And also, we should have that hard bargain. And when we join, please understand, especially in this era of global uncertainties, and there are so many challenges in multilateralism. There are economic slowdown going on across the globe. The economy is not growing the way we would like to have. So, any attempt by India to sit outside, or rather preventing RCEP or sitting outside RCEP, will definitely undermine India's economic growth and India's plans for a higher economic growth. Yes, there are challenges in many manufacturing sectors. We need to overcome, government should focus, give some subsidy if required, strengthen those sectors. Rather than saying that we are weak, so we will not allow others to come into the market. So, we should strengthen our sectors, we should help those sectors, we should identify, even in agriculture, we should focus on agriculture, train our Indian farmers to compete by increasing our productivity. Rather than saying we are weak in agriculture, so we don't want to open up our economy for outside. So, unfortunately, the problem which has happened is, especially after economic liberalization, we opened our economy without giving sufficient support and sufficient cushion for our Indian manufacturers and Indian agriculturists. But on the whole, this is going to be the largest trade bloc of the world. India should not be thinking of sitting outside. India should make a hard bargain, get maximum concession so that we are not adversely affected that much. And whichever sector is going to be adversely affected, whether it is sugar industry, whether it is steel industry, whether it is aluminium industry, whatever manufacturing it is going to be affected, India government should support them, support by way of various other benefits, so that they can compete with the international market and succeed in competing with them and make our manufacturing more stronger and powerful. So, India should not be thinking of sitting outside. If everything goes well, by the end of this year, RCEP, a free trade agreement among the 16 countries, are going to be a reality, and India should be a part of it.